Hello everyone. I thought I'd come on today showing how the easiest way to how I do the scroll fans. The scroll fans like for birthday parties, any type of celebration that you might be having. They mainly been making them now for graduation and such things like that. Undo everything that I have done and start from scratch. Okay, I went to Google and searched for scrolls . You don't necessarily have to look for PNG scrolls, because the way you have to do it, it doesn't recommend it to be PNG, because you'll be deleting areas out. This is an easier way of doing it. I watched a video the other day that was by Crafts of a Different Shade, if I'm pronouncing that right. She showed an extensive video, and I do recommend that you watch her video, because she shows you a lot of editing that you could do to your pictures. Okay, I'm just looking for the template that I use. Okay, you could just, I don't see that template right now, unless I just keep looking over it, but we'll just try this for demonstration on purpose. Well, that one is a, that's not a, okay, we'll use this one. You'll have to excuse me with the clearing of my voice, because I suffer with allergies, so you'll probably hear that a lot. So I saved it to my computer. And now I'll be going to upload it. Going to my pictures. Here it is right here. Okay, and then I'll be using the complex one. Click continue, and I'll be just clearing out the background and keeping the image the way it is. Okay, and I save as a print then cut image. And I and then I'm going to upload the image again. Same thing, and this time I'll be clearing out everything. You'll save it as a print then cut image again. Okay, and but I won't be using these two images. I'll be using, because I like the other fans, the other scrolls that I downloaded at another time. I like these two images better. And you want to insert these two images on your and by the way, if I didn't mention it, I'm working with Design Space. Okay, and you want to make these two images the same size, so you want to group them together and maybe even attach. Then resize them that way. Okay, we'll leave them about that size. Then detach. Ungroup. They should be about the same size. One is just a tad bit bigger than the other. One is just a tad bit bigger than the other, so okay, because you want them to be able to fit right on top of each other. Okay, so now we're going to whatever picture that you want to put in your scroll, you want to make sure that you download it and save the picture from Google or from whatever image that you might want to use, like a picture of your loved one or a picture of the person that you're doing the scrolls for. Or you might want to, like I said, save a picture from Google, in which I did that. Which I saved a picture from Google, just for demonstration purposes. And this is the picture right here. But I also uploaded in the pattern field. You want to and then browse. Which I'll try this one. You want to name the picture. We'll call this Rose Gold. And just and you might want to pick a theme or a color recommendation or something like that. And you click save, and it'll be saved into your patterns. Okay, so now we'll just go back to, come on now. We'll just click cancel. Okay, and now we're back to the screen that we're working on. Okay. Now you want to add your pattern. Okay, now you want to add your pattern. Okay, and we're going to go here. We've added the pattern. And now we want to change the color of the, we're going to call this part of the scroll the frame. And I'm going to change it to this candy corn color. Okay, we want to go to arrange and move the frame to the front. We also can highlight both of the pictures, the frame and the picture, and go to align and just click center, and it'll do that for us. Center the frame around the picture. Then once you have everything the way you want it, you want to go to group, and then you want to flag. Okay, and then you want to and once you have everything the way you like it, the size and all, because you can still resize everything. Resize it to the size you want to make it smaller or bigger. Then you want to go to make it. I'm not actually going to do this because I've already printed one out and have it ready for Cricut and already have it ready for Cricut to cut. So I click continue, but I'm not going to print it because like I said, I already have one printed and everything ready to go. And if you can see it right here. I'm gonna click I've already print. Then we'll go to my okay, I'm sending it to through the Cricut. Okay, I'm going to stop the video right now, and I'll be back with the finished look.